Eyewitness identifications play an extremely important role both in the investigation and the prosecution of crime. And sometimes they go horribly wrong, as has been highlighted by the work of the Innocence Project. There are consequences to this failure, one of which is the fact that the wrong people go to jail and the guilty people go free. This also undermines the public trust in the criminal justice system. Recognizing these issues, the Laura and John Arnold Foundation came forward to the National Academy of Sciences and requested an investigation into the relevance of science to this problem of eyewitness identification. The National Academy formed a committee. It's co-chaired by me and a federal judge by the name of Jed Rakoff. There are 14 members of the committee, and these are people who are experts in fields of science, statistics, law, and law enforcement. In particular, we looked at basic research on the topics of human visual perception and memory. If you're witnessing a crime, your visual system and your memory system are the ones that both acquire the information and retain that information, enable you to recall it later. Applied research has led to the identification of two main classes of variables that affect eyewitness identification. The first of these is known as system variable. Witnesses are, in general, they're trying to perform well. They want to help. And so if they get signals, something like police officer says, "Are you sure?" And by simply questioning the output of the witness, the police officer is in a position of influencing the witness's judgment. The other type of variable that's been identified are the so-called estimator variables, factors such as your level of stress or emotion. There are other critical factors such as the presence of a weapon. Your attention will be immediately drawn to that stimulus, and this has the effect of distracting your attention away from the things that are critical for identification, namely the face of the criminal. At some point, the eyewitness will be asked in court to identify the suspect, and the eyewitness will say, "That's the guy," and they'll say this with complete confidence, which, if you think about it, is completely irrational. This is a probabilistic world. All they can do is say this with a certain level of probability, but they assert this with 100% confidence. So this is really an act of theater, but it nonetheless has a big impact on the jury. And so to overcome that, it's important that a confidence statement be made at the time of the initial inquiry so that we can use that information later. It's important that the legal system make sure that jurors are apprised of those factors that influence eyewitness identifications, that judges are aware of the fallibility of visual perception and memory. The legal and law enforcement communities should take into account information that's gained through the most recent scientific research on these topics. And so we're recommending a broad national research initiative. Our hope is that by bringing together scientists and individuals from law enforcement, we're in a better position to reform the criminal justice system and reduce the chance that individuals who are innocent get sent to jail.